god must be around here somewhere. That voice!
I can feel it. It's the vile god. He must be further inside.
By the way, Aaron, can you possibly revive the goddess's power? Even reduced, it's still the power of the vile god. I imagine things would go better for us if we had the fully revived goddess's power on our side.
We've done everything we can, so there's no reason she can't revive. But even I'm not sure of what I'm supposed to do next. If there's any sort of problem, it would be up to Fang to...
Huh?
Speaking of which, where is Fang? He was just here a second ago.
Sorry about that. Nature calls, you know. Once I got started, it just wouldn't stop. Honestly, I think I set a personal record.
You're ruining the dramatic tension! Taking this seriously at all?
What do you want me to do? When you gotta go, you gotta go! What, you want a partner who pees himself in the middle of the fight?
Oh no, I definitely wouldn't want that.
Right? The rest of you better go too, while you still can.
I'm fine. I don't do that.
Stop lying. I saw you go in the bathroom last night.
Only because it's the ideal place to be alone and focus on my meditation.
Why don't you just admit it already?
Don't assume every human is the same as you. There are all kinds of different people in the world.
Yeah, and they all go to the bathroom.
Please, that's enough. Is now really the best time to be having this conversation?
The goddess's power doesn't want to revive with a partner like this.
What? What'd you just say?
Nothing. Come on, let's go.
Sit.
Thank you.
this guy again.
Zenke!
Kill you, kill you, kill you! This time I'll kill all of you, I swear!
I told you before, if you stand in our way again, we will show you no mercy.
Shut up! Don't tell me what to do up there on your high horse! I'm gonna kill everyone!
What's up with this guy? He's creeping me out.
He seems to have lost his grip on reality, poor fellow.
I saw Galdo die! Do you know how amazing that felt? I want to see more people. More! More!
What the hell did you just say?
Go ahead, say it again! I'll say it as many times as I want! Human death is the greatest show on the planet! And Galdo's idiot face when he died was hilarious! You son of a bitch!
There's no point in trying to talk to him. If he wants to stand in our way, we have no choice but to fight him.
Oh, you're gonna kill me? Just try. Just you try.
Here he comes.
Let's go, Chewie!
Let's do this. Okay, so one of the final bosses of the game here is Zenke. I really don't know why they chose him here, since he really was kind of a throwaway. It would have been kind of interesting if he at least had some sort of different personality instead of Galdo's death triggering him like he did. And on hard mode, so he has millions of HP.
New data.
Not quite a million, though, but pretty high armor. And since I don't really care to analyze him, I don't actually know if I bother at all for dealing 8,000 damage per Gaia Sphere right up at the gate. Now, the downside is, since I wasn't really anticipating a fight here, I'm not properly healed. I don't know how he is in terms of damage, so I wanted to make sure I was topped off just in case he actually had some threat to him, but he doesn't. So like usual, Monkey King Punch is giving us all the tension we could possibly use. And with a single solitary enemy, there's no way for the others to actually get enough tension to your eyes immediately. It's just Fang and Pippin leading the way. So now that we're transformed, let's go ahead and hit him with the Flame Assault. You know, in retrospect, it's kind of disappointing that I never actually got around to using the other moves, the big ones that actually cost HP. For the most part, I think they fall off for the most part, unless you're going to use them as executes, and even then I'm still a little scared to use them at times because I'm afraid that my guys may not quite finish them off. You'll survive with like 1-2 hit points, and then use some sort of move that's going to hit them for 75% of their HP, killing them. Anyways, since Ethel got hit by him, that generated enough hits for her to actually Fairize. Here's the analysis. You can see he drops the blue orb that we need in order to go find the common boss. And once you beat him, if you have the red orb, you can actually just use backtrack and go to the start of the dungeon and go forward. I think I linger around a little bit looking for stuff, but eventually I do give up and just head on out. The other reason why I would encourage you to use backtrack is because that'll put you on the world map so you'll fully heal. Now we'll be able to fight the final boss at full health, and the boss does pack a bit of a punch. So I don't know if it's my imagination or we really are dropping frames left and right here.
Take this!
And since Fairizing on Harley is no priority, there's just no reason to rush it. It will increase her damage, yes, it's just you'd have to sacrifice the immediate damage of the Gaia Sphere. Best case scenario is you do want to group Harley with someone that's going to get hit so she can absorb some extra damage and use that for attention. But Galdo, or not Galdo, Zenke is so weak that it's just not gonna happen. As for the whole wax impressive thing here, I was trying to experiment with Ethel's moves to find out which one actually does the most damage. And since I resolved to go to the world map before fighting the final boss at here, yeah, I can go ahead and burn SP on Pippin. Same reasoning behind me using Soul Crusher here. I'm just curious to see how it does in terms of damage. And yeah, pretty impressive, huh? Gold we can break 10k, which will really help you shred through the massive HP pools on guys on, well, bosses on, hard or hell mode. In case you're wondering about a hell mode run, that's simply not happening for one reason. For one, the DLC does not consistently work for me, so when I have time to record, it may not be working, and thus I can't do hell mode. If you notice the world map, whenever I play, sometimes the DLC is there, sometimes it's not. That's pretty much the reason why, and that's the reason why I'm not doing hell mode. If I were to do it, I'd have to do it off camera, and the uploads would probably be kind of sporadic. My goal is to get the third arc recorded by Tuesday. Let's see, this is going up Sunday. So I plan to have the entire game uploaded by then. I don't know if I'll be able to do Shukesu's Tower in full by then, but I'm hoping to be able to get all of the endings, well, just the generic endings, and I can worry about the character endings when I have time. So yeah, the timeline's getting a little tense as this game winds down, Morgana winds down, and then a new game rises up and I have to try to squeeze in Setsuna somewhere.
Here.
In case you're wondering, I do have other episodes of Setsuna recorded, it's just this gameplay has monopolized my editing software. As a result, I only have this. Basically, whenever the editing software is up, I have to do something with Fairy Fencer. I will try to splice Sentinels whenever I get some downtime, since there is some interest for those. I'm almost at the point where, still gonna be some time for these, but I'm almost at the point where I can start recording the bits as they come. Anyway, that's enough of a channel update. We have knocked Zenke down to his final life bar, and my goal is to try to end it this turn. So that's the level 6 challenge. I think 7 is the finale, and the challenges aren't worth as much as they were in the original game, which is a little disappointing. Usually you get like 100 point boosts this game. It's like 30, I want to say, at most. And since the two have history, we have to let Galdo deliver the finishing blow to Zenke. It's only poetic justice, you know?
It's over! Sorry about that! It hurts! Hey, if you want to say something, say it now! Apologize for Galdo, and I'll at least let you live.
As if I would ever apologize. Death of a person is the most beautiful thing.
Bastard!
And now, I will become beautiful!
So he's chosen to end his own life.
Beautiful. I am beautiful.
You fool.
However, now Dorfa's fighting force has been all but obliterated.
Which means it's finally time for our final confrontation with the Vile God.
Stay sharp, Fang. It's your fault the goddess's power hasn't revived. Try and make sure you aren't totally useless.
Shut up! It's not my fault! Besides, we don't need her power anyway. We've made it this far without it, haven't we?
I hope you're right.
We'll be right back.
that?
It's Mariana. Has she been absorbed by the Vile God?
But she's not moving. Maybe they're already dead.
Oh, you arrived sooner than expected.
You've, changed since the last time we saw you. Didn't anyone ever tell you too much plastic surgery is bad for you?
Not to worry. In fact, I'm in very good health. I've been getting plenty of sleep, you see.
How could you be so foolish as to merge with the Vile God?
It was the only chance I had. Was for now, this time.
Guard is gone?
Everyone, be careful! The Vile God is even more powerful than he was before!
What? No way! We got Tiara out of there! He should be weaker!
Wait, does that mean that Bernard?
He's inside the Vile God, that's right. I fought Bernard to him, you see. But Tiara got... This was the only blood that could reawaken him.
Done.
But without Bernard, I couldn't control the awakened Vile God, which is why I chose to become one with it instead. I have abandoned my humanity. I don't mind. I can feel his power coursing through me. I've never felt anything so amazing. With this power, I can... I can control the world.
Huh? She's acting strange.
If you don't have the Vile God's blood, it's impossible to control him. No, even with the Vile God's blood, this is not the kind of power any human should try to control.
That's not true. I have obtained complete power. I'm just not used to it yet.
So now we confront a fully awakened Vile God. Eren, what about the goddess's power?
Oh god! It still hasn't awakened!
Everyone shut up! All that matters is what you do with the power you have! I don't like leaving things up to gods. I don't know about you, Mariana, but if I want to get something done, I do it myself! Come on, Eren! Let's finish this!
Right!
There I am!
And here we are with the final boss of the playthrough. So in case you're wondering, there are no multiple stages to this. It's just straight up Vile God. The game was nice enough to start us off in Fair Eyes mode for Fang, so we can go ahead and just start getting her right out the gate from that regard. Let's see, we almost took off half the wide bar, but she is pretty damn durable. And most of the HP bars are bigger than normal.
New data. Now then.
So one of the hard parts about this boss is just getting to her, and if you're wondering what I mean, all of her stuff has sort of like a knockback effect to push you further and further away from her. As a result, I can't actually reach her with any of Pippin's moves. I have to just punch her a couple times. And that's the challenge to the fight. She's gonna knock you back, and you need to make sure that your healers can actually heal in the formation she knocks you into. See what I mean? How everyone went a different direction. Outside of all Harley stuff, I think even the ground thrust. I really didn't want to use that because it's 300 SP. Even though Harley does have the biggest pool, I think, out of anyone. As for my healer here, Tiara, she got knocked back pretty far, but I'm still able to get the four of them inside of range. Ethel, on the other hand, got hit twice before she was able to make a single move, so there's nothing she can do. Pretty much, I have to leave Galdo on healing duty with Tiara just so I don't get overwhelmed. And remember, last turn, I had to just punch the Vile God. I couldn't actually use Monkey King Punch. As a result of that, I had to use it this turn in order to generate enough tension for Kingdom of Fairies. In case you're curious, we are about to go on to a different video file than the Zenke fight, so hopefully the whole drop frame thing goes away soon. But anyway, right here, Fang and Ethel are too far apart. I could have just used it on Fang, but I decided to go for the full healing, or that was ultra heal. So I got hit in where I lost the pair of eyes, but the guy was just flame assault to get back up there. Sadly, from where you start, you're going to fall a little short, but we can do that next turn. We'll probably have max tension then. In case you don't remember the tutorials at the beginning of the game, your damage does scale with tension, so Fang should be dealing a little bit more than he used to. See right there, Ethel is just getting screwed over royally here. She's finally able to attack with something other than her freezing meteor, and it took this long.
Transformation complete. Do my best.
So right there, you can see the damage leaves a lot to be desired. So your goal here is to heal your teammates without healing the Vile God. Don't forget the heals from Tiara or spells, they heal for percentages, not blood amounts. When you're dealing with an opponent that has something like 300,000 hit points, that 10% is actually quite a lot. Especially when you consider my guys are dealing 10,000 damage per turn. You really don't. You're forced to. Even then, it's still very undesirable. Now, since Tiara and Galdo don't get turns, I need to use an item here to keep them going. Okay, is that just me trying to provide the commentary, or is it really that choppy?
My turn.
So you can see that was 5,000 damage. Ethel, for some reason, just can't keep up. I'm not entirely sure what the problem is either.
Healing form transformation complete.
Tear rise complete.
Executing.
Then again, Finn. Yeah, he actually did 10,000. They're closer to 12,000. I wonder if I might have been better off bringing Sherman or Alola to this fight.
Alright, let's go!
Executing Soul Crusher.
Quiet now! Die!
So you can see Galdo doesn't really have much of a problem with DPS.
Here we go!
So yeah, it looks like the majority of my guys are hovering between 10 to 12,000. And the moment you guys have probably been waiting for. Harley can theorize and now start throwing out the empowered Gaia spears.
Transformation complete!
Let's go!
Executing Gaia spear!
Go!
13,000 without a crit. Devastating. So right there is the weakest of the Vile God's arsenal, if I remember. The key thing to know is that you... right there, if you notice, the level 7 challenges are giving 10 of each stat. 10 vitality, that is. I want to say in the original game that would have given you like 100 vitality or something. That's one of the things that got nerfed in the move here. And now I forgot my original train of thought, but oh well. Oh, the weakest attack. So it does reposition you a little bit. That's pretty much the only danger to it, I'd say. It does have a lot of power behind it. Pretty much it's your one turn reprieve to heal, get all the stuff out that you need to, and then you basically need to get back in the fray. So let's see if we'll get lucky, and this time it'll be a crit. 12,900 was the damage last time. This is 13.5 without a crit. So if you look at the gauge, the turn order on the left side, it will flash when the spell you're casting will affect the people involved, see? You want to make sure that the Vile God's icon is not flashing when you cast that healing spell, otherwise you lose quite a bit of ground. Did about 11,000, I want to say. And poor, poor Ethel just can't keep up. The bad part is she doesn't actually have the speed in this fight to make up lost ground either, like with a crit that was 7,000 instead of 5. Maybe Vile God has some sort of innate resistance to bow type moves or scythe moves too. Well, Galdo's using an axe in that one.
Join the cosmos. Here we go.
Anyway, there are about 2 bars of health left. Let's see if we'll be lucky and have our crit Gaia spear here just yet. Back down to 12,000. That's probably the weakest one yet, now that I think about it. Just make sure all the icons are flashing to the characters you want it to flash to, and then cast it. The thing you do have to watch out for here is I can't... Can I get them all? Like, I can. I was afraid I wouldn't be able to hit both Pippin and Galdo, but here comes the big shot. That is probably the most devastating of the Vile God's moves. And it does punish you for grouping up like I'm doing here. It's just I have enough resources to where I can withstand all the damage coming my way. $11,300. Ethel lost her fair eyes. So let's see how much Luna's doing distance here. We'll start with $11,300. Almost 9,000. I should have been using that the entire time, I guess. Yeah, maybe she's resistant to scythes and bows or something. Fists and axe seem to be doing just fine.
Join the cosmos. Here we go.
So right here I want to end the fight a certain way. That's why I'm not going to have Harley deal the finishing blow with her spear. Instead, we need to let the Vile God get one last turn before we can end this with style. Slash. Or did I thought I used floating slash, did I use once? Yeah, basically me saying the Vile God was not worth the finishing touch. Plus there was also the fear that this was not the final boss, which is why I didn't want to blow all the HP. Otherwise, had I known, I would have went for the showmanship ending. But anyway, here comes the ending of the Vile God route.
happen? If I know, my body just does what it wants.
What's going on? I feel power deep inside of me.
The faith drop, it's reacting. Could this be the goddess's power?
Hey, you did it! It's the goddess's power. It looks like she's finally revived. I can hear it. The voice of the goddess. She said she awakened because of your desire to protect Tiara, the girl with the vile god's blood.
Seriously? Sounds like she almost overslept. But better late than never.
We can seal the vile god now. Use her power. Do it, Fang!
I wanted to do this with my own power. Oh well. I'll accept this heavenly favor just once. Goddess, give me your power!
Whose fate had been distorted by the vile god's power, did not return to normal as expected. The world went on, as did its people, living with the memory and the scars of the vile god. This new flow of time remained unchanged.
Step right up! I've got the deal of a century here! You can look, you can touch!
Miss Lola, what are you selling today?
Some new Dorfa product. I bought a bunch for cheap when Dorfa went under. They just aren't selling at all.
Well, millions of people see Dorfa as pure evil now. Who would go near their stuff? I helped develop some of it too, so I'm kinda conflicted.
With Dorfa and the vile god gone, I thought I could finally return to business as usual. My plans got all messed up.
Lots of people were left jobless after Dorfa collapsed. You'll just have to be patient and wait for the economy to recover.
Well, Harley, maybe you could at least take a look at this. Sashimi in a can. It's a truly groundbreaking culinary delight.
That's one of mine. It was supposed to keep the sashimi fresh and cool. But thanks to a defect during manufacturing, they all spoiled. They still had some of those left, huh? Boy, that takes me back.
Bunch of useless junk?
Well, there's no happiness without suffering, right? Do your best, okay?
I'm way in the red on this one.
You bastard! You took everything I own! I just wanted to rob you a little!
No need to panic, my boy. Soji is washing your clothes as we speak.
I finished the wash. I'm just ironing them now.
Quick work, as always.
Okay, all done. Please try this on.
Hey! Knock it off. I can't wear such clean clothes.
How does it fit? I fixed the sleeves while I was at it. They seemed a little too long.
I feel like my soul has been washed clean. Why did I ever want to be a bandit in the first place?
If that's how you feel, you should live your life for others. Dirty clothes reveal a dirty soul. You must keep your soul well-groomed.
Oh, okay.
Now then, on to the next destination. Even with the vile god gone, the world still suffers from chaos.
Of course, Pippin.
A martial arts teacher?
That's right. I work for a security company now, and they need a good teacher. It's a perfect fit for you, don't you think?
I must decline. I honed my blade for my own sake. It is not something I wish to teach to others.
Apollonius! How long do you plan to keep using that excuse to avoid getting a job? The world is at peace! What's the point of just honing your blade all the time? This is a good opportunity. Take it!
Apollonius cringe.
Leave him alone, Vivian. So, what do you think, Apollonius? Bring you on right now with very favorable contract terms.
I understand. I suppose you can let them know I'm interested.
As always, but please wait just a moment while I prepare our meals.
Okay.
Thank you for all you've done, Kiara. With your help, we were able to save our orphanage, even without Dorfa's support.
You really don't have to thank me. This is just my way of atoning.
Yes, I'm aware of your past, but as long as you are penitent, you are not a criminal in our eyes.
I'm atoning for my entire existence, including the blood that flows within me. Ethel, you need to get up sooner, you'll be late. No, not 5 more minutes. You said that 5 minutes ago. You're the one who wanted to start going to school. Now come on, wake up. Up, up, up! Go get washed! Breakfast is waiting for you. It's perfectly normal to go to class every day. Here, get dressed.
The Vile God is gone. But the past we left behind hasn't returned. All those who died are still. I'm so sorry, sister. I thought perhaps you might yet live within this world. But even if not, if the power I wield can serve some small role in protecting this world, would that be enough to be forgiven?
We'll be right back.
Deku.
Damn, it's cold.
Ah, tapping out in this cold weather? You've developed some odd hobbies.
Hey there, Sherman. Perfect timing. Let me borrow a few bucks.
We haven't seen each other in who knows how long. And those are the first words out of your mouth?
I can't help it. I don't have any money. I don't even have enough to get a room at the inn.
I'm surprised you're still here. After telling everyone you were going to travel the world, and just picking up and leaving?
Well, I went a little wild in the first town I got to. I got the hotel's nice suite and ordered all the room service. Then boom, bankrupt.
Are you sure you aren't missing part of your brain?
Just shut up and lend me some money.
Very well. On one condition.
What is it?
I have no way of knowing if you'll ever pay me back. So, allow me to accompany you until you return it.
What? That's all you want? Yeah, sure, whatever. Now, give me that moolah.
Please, do try and pay me back.
I will. When have I ever lied to you?
Look in my eyes. You'll see the truth. You're asking me to gaze into your eyes underneath a starry night sky? Are you trying to tell me something?
No, you idiot! You're the more likely candidate anyway with that girly hair.
Enough of this pointless bickering. I'll lend you the money, so let's head into town and find an inn. I have no desire to camp out here.
Right, then let's go.
Sherman, why do you insist on following this man?
I simply want to observe for myself, the man who possesses what I lack.
Hey, we'll leave you behind if you don't hurry up.
Yes, I'm well aware.
So that's the default ending for the Vile God route, Sherman's ending. There are other routes that I'll be worrying about later, but in the meantime, we need to start the next route and get that one on the road, and then we can come back and get the different endings for the different characters. And like I said, I'm going down to normal. You can see Hell isn't even here because the DLC isn't working. By the way, next stop,
long ago,
the evil goddess.